Did you know that painkillers sitting in your medicine cabinet right now could attack your heart? That's right. NSAIDs or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs like ibuprofen or diclofenac might help your joint or the back pain, but they could also increase your risk for heart attacks. So how exactly do they affect your heart? And there are any safer NSAIDs than others? And what are the natural alternatives that can help you be pain-free but without the risk? In this video, we will talk about all of this. And I will also share with you a very common NSAID that could increase your risk for heart attacks much more than others. So stay with me to learn about it. What are NSAIDs and how do they work? Millions of people take NSAIDs every day. NSAIDs are among the most widely used pain relievers in the world. And in the United States, the common NSAIDs include ibuprofen, naproxen, meloxicam, diclofenac, and celecoxib. As doctors, we prescribe NSAIDs to reduce the fever, inflammation, and pain. But they are also available over the counter, so people can buy them. And they do work by blocking cyclooxygenase enzymes, specifically COX-1 and COX-2, which are responsible for producing prostaglandins. And these are some chemicals that cause pain and inflammation. However, COX-1 also protects the stomach lining and regulates blood clotting, while COX-2 plays a role in inflammation. Blocking these enzymes can also lead to unintended side effects. Now, here is the problem. Many people assume that these medications are completely safe, but they are not. How exactly do NSAIDs impact your heart? When NSAIDs block COX-2, they reduce prostacyclin, which is a chemical that protects the blood vessels from clots and inflammation. But while this level of prostacyclin drops, NSAIDs will not stop the production of another chemical that promotes clotting, and this is called thromboxane A2. This imbalance increases the cardiovascular risk, and over time, the excessive use of NSAIDs can lead to heart attacks, to strokes, to heart failure, to higher blood pressure or hypertension, to atrial fibrillation, and to the risk of developing blood clots in the vessels. But here it is, the big question. Are all NSAIDs equally risky? And the answer is no. Not all NSAIDs are created equal, especially when it comes to the risk of attacking the heart. Higher doses of diclofenac or COX-2 inhibitors like celecoxib are known to increase the risk of cardiovascular events significantly. In the meantime, naproxen appears to have a better safety profile for your heart. A study that was published in 2013 in Lancet, which is a very respected medical journal, brought us more information about NSAIDs. In this meta-analysis, which included hundreds of studies and about 300,000 participants, it showed that diclofenac, ibuprofen, and Celebrex increase the risk for stroke, for heart attacks, for heart failure, and death because of cardiac reasons, but it also increased the risk to develop upper GI complications like perforation and bleeding. And on the contrary, naproxen did not show to increase the risk of heart disease. But the dose was also a significant factor because higher doses of diclofenac or ibuprofen or celecoxib shows to be more risky. And similarly, the PRECISION trial, which was published in 2005 in New England Journal of Medicine, which is another reputable medical publication, it revealed that higher doses of celecoxib, like 200 milligrams twice a day, will increase the risk for heart disease, while lower doses seems to be less dangerous. So what makes some people more vulnerable to develop heart disease from NSAIDs? If you already have heart disease, high blood pressure, diabetes, a history of smoking, then you have to know your risk is much higher. Even for people that are healthy, the long-term use or high doses of NSAIDs, it is dangerous. Now, let me tell you the story of one of my patients. Jim, he was 55 years old and he had osteoarthritis of his knees. For many years, he was using ibuprofen every day, and that was despite my efforts to convince him that this is bad for him. I offer him diclofenac cream, capsaicin cream, I offer him even CBD cream, but he was not willing to give up his ibuprofen because he was convinced that this was the only medications that helped him. But one day, he started to feel chest pain. His heart was pounding and he developed a severe headache. He called my office and the first thing that I told him to do was to check his blood pressure. And guess what? His blood pressure was 190 over 110. And he was a guy who never had high blood pressure before. Then when I asked him what did he do in the last couple of weeks, he told me that because of pain, because of the changing weather, he had more pain in the knees and he started to take more ibuprofen. He was actually taking between 4 and 6 pills every day. So what did I do? I sent him directly to the emergency room to control his blood pressure. And after his blood pressure was controlled, we had a serious discussion and he finally agreed to stop using ibuprofen every day. But now you are probably asking, so what are the alternatives? What can I do to relieve my pain without harming my heart? And fortunately, there are some natural alternatives that can reduce the pain, can reduce inflammation without the risk of having a heart attack. Let me talk to you about those options. Number one is fish oil or omega-3 supplements. These supplements can act on the same enzyme, the COX enzyme, like NSAIDs do, and they do reduce inflammation and pain. And there are many studies in people with rheumatoid arthritis, psoriatic arthritis, lupus, and even in people with back pain that show that the use of omega-3s is protective for your heart because they reduce the cholesterol, they reduce the triglycerides, but it's also important because they reduce inflammation, they reduce swelling, morning stiffness, and they will reduce the back pain. And on top of that, they don't have the significant side effects of NSAIDs. The number two is turmeric or the golden spice because it contains curcumin and this is a potent anti-inflammatory component. And there are again many studies to support the use of turmeric either in foods or as a supplement. And in my other videos, I presented many studies that support the addition of turmeric as a supplement and that will reduce the inflammation, the swelling, the number of painful joints. And we have studies coming from patients with rheumatoid arthritis, with lupus, psoriatic arthritis, and it is proven that the addition of turmeric, it is helpful. Now, let me talk to you about a cream. The capsaicin cream. And this is a topical pain reliever from the active compound found in chili peppers. And it works by blocking a substance called substance P, which is a chemical that in our body will transmit pain signals to the brain. And by reducing the pain sensation, capsaicin cream is often used to relieve muscle pain, but also joint pain, and it helps arthritis. And now let me tell you about another cream, the CBD cream or CBD oil. And there are some studies that they show that the use of CBD may impact the level of inflammation at the brain level, but it can also reduce the markers of inflammation in the joints. And in 2022, a study on CBD showed that 80% of people that use that show to have improvement in the pain level, improvement in the physical function, and 66% showed to have an improvement in their sleep quality. Although people report that CBD helped them with arthritis, you have to understand that there are no rigorous clinical studies that we have at this point in people with arthritis to confirm what people say. But if you still need NSAIDs, there is no need to panic. You just need to be smart about it. And here it is what I would recommend. Always discuss with your doctor because they will be able to tell you if NSAIDs are safe or not for you. And I know from many years of experience that if I don't ask, many patients do not even think to tell me what are the medications that they take over the counter. So once again, just because you don't need that prescription to take them, to buy them, it doesn't mean that they are harmless. And don't forget to use the lower dose for the shortest time possible and monitor your symptoms. Watch for chest pain, watch for shortness of breath, for swelling in the legs, and check your blood pressure often. And if you take something from this, consider natural options like fish oil, like turmeric, like diclofenac gel or capsaicin gel or capsaicin cream or CBD cream. And now that you have learned about how NSAIDs can be dangerous for your heart, you should also learn more about natural remedies, some that are doctor approved. Because if you don't, you are not gonna know how to manage the pain from arthritis. And because of that, you might try things that are actually damaging your body. And you should learn about all of this right here.